Thoma Ewen, how are you?
Good, thank you.
This is the last day of your show.
Yes.
It's a dual show with the Gabi Ewen.
Yes, the last day of Materia Linea.
And you're going to give a talk later, which yes. I will video record as well.
Great.
This is your most recent work here?
This is not actually. This is from several years ago. It's a series called Sacred Blanket. This is one of the series. This piece is called Sacred Blanket for a Warrior Maiden, the Ties That Bind. And it's woven out of sisal on a cotton warp and wrapped with copper wire. So, and copper wire sewn throughout the piece. And I've also used a little bit of pastel here. There's a little crescent moon. A crescent moon is the sign of the goddess. And these are all the ends of the weaving, which I brought out to the front and wrapped in copper wire. Yeah. So this is, you know, really an experimental piece.
It's very different from the other pieces.
Yes. Woven in sisal, which is a natural fiber, a wonderful rough kind of fiber, which has a totally primitive feel. It's almost like you can hear drums beating when you are working with it.
Yes. And this yellow.
Yeah, the yellow is pastel. So it's in the shape of a crescent moon.
Yes.
And actually the moon rain, you know, the original moon rain is a crescent moon.
It stands out.
Yeah.
We can see it from here. It's beautiful. Mm-hmm. And you have a few more pieces over there.
Yes, I have two other series here. So parts of three series. This little piece is the Horizon of Peace series. I wove six tapestries. This was number one, winter. So it's really a winter horizon. I was exhibiting in Guatemala and Venezuela through Canadian External Affairs one year, and also taught and gave lectures in the art museums there. A wonderful tour of art galleries through Canadian External Affairs. And when I came back, I got ill from drinking water. And I wanted to weave, but I was sort of not terribly well. I could only weave in straight lines. But when I came back, I noticed how peace stretched across our horizon. When I landed in Ottawa, it was like this calm stretched across the horizon in Ottawa, which I think for the first time in my life I understood what peace was. Guatemala was just about to end a 36-year civil war when I was there, and guns were everywhere. So when I came back, you know, I really began to understand what peace is, and I did six of these horizons that follow the light, the changing light over the years. So this was winter, and then it went through spring, summer, fall to the next winter. Did six of these tapestries in that series.
And I believe one was also in that international exhibition, Orealis.
That isn't part of this series.
Oh, it's not?
That's another series. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And there's another one.
Yeah, I have four tapestries here that are part of a series called Light Refraction Tapestries. And this piece is crossover. And in Light Refraction Tapestries, it was an intuitive exploration of energy flow patterns. And so I just depicted them as these really quite flowing lines. And so as we go around, you'll see different sort of formations of the way light moves. And with this one, I thought when I first did it that, you know, the red was the male and the blue was the female. And then after weaving it, I thought, I'm not so sure. Maybe the female is the red. And so anyway, it's just...
And it's also how we relate to the colors.
Yeah.
And all this glitter, I see this shimmering.
I have a little silver thread woven into the wool. So my yarn bundles, I think I've sometimes even have eight different fibers in the yarn bundles that I weave with, including a little metallic fiber in this series of light refraction tapestries.
And there is another one. This one is part of the series that we just saw here. This one, are these two related? These two?
Yes, these four, the four big tapestries woven out of wool, are all part of light refraction tapestries. Yeah, these four. They were all woven at about 5 feet high and 7 feet wide, approximately, all of them. I wove 10 of them. And they've been exhibited around the world, actually, this series, which is quite wonderful. So there are four here in this show. I chose work that would complement Gabby's work. Gabby's work's very delicate. So I didn't want to have anything kind of bright and imposing as a backdrop. I thought these tapestries would kind of be quite harmonious with the jewelry. So that's all.
Yes, because she's doing this weaving with metal and stones, and they're also inserting this metallic threads in your art.
Yes, yeah, I thought there was a lot of harmony. When we finally got the show set up, we really sort of thought, gee, this is actually beautiful. It works very beautifully together. So I guess it's not surprising, but we weren't, you know, we weren't totally sure. We're very happy with the way this show looks, actually. So this one is called Enter the Spiral. And really it was more that this incredible spiral form and spiral energy kind of entered my consciousness, and I had to do it. And really the whole series was like that. It was very abstract, and really it was almost like the designs for these kind of demanded to be woven, and that's how I felt at the time.
You seem to be very careful on how you present your work, and you pay attention on how this work is translated at our subconscious level.
I am very careful about my work, yes. I am a bit of a perfectionist. I think I'm an artist, and my prime motivation is to communicate, you know, what I feel, what I need to express. Sometimes I don't even totally understand it. And this was the way this series was. It was almost like it came through the unconscious, and I had to do it. At the time, prior to this, I was doing very colorful things and really more realistic. And so this was quite abstract and sort of different, but really the designs were absolutely pushing me to do it. But it's very much, you know, energy flowing, very beautiful energy that really flows through us. It's all around us, it's life, it's the life force. And there it is. And how it affects people's subconscious, well, I hope it affects them in a good way.
Oh, that's for sure. Can we go a little closer to that?
Yeah.
When you decide on the sizes, it depends on your loom or the demand?
I love big. Personally, I love big, yeah. I find it hard to work small. I feel like someone is trying to, you know, encase me in elastic. So I need to work big, and my favorite loom allows me to weave a maximum about 8 feet wide. So all of these were woven on my favorite loom, and most of these are 7 feet wide, 5 feet high.
The triennial just ended.
Yes.
How do you feel about it?
I feel that it was an incredible success. I feel that really every aspect we met our goals. We had a series of extraordinary exhibitions all over Gatineau and Ottawa and all over this region of Quebec. The fact that the Pontiac School of the Arts wanted to participate as a collaborator, and Saint-André-Avalon, you know, the city of Gatineau, aspects of the city of Ottawa, Elmont, the Mississippi Valley Textile Museum, the fact that they all wanted to collaborate with us. It was a very enriching experience for me to be able to work with them to program those exhibitions. So all of these really major centers were happy to work with me to accept the programming exhibitions that I offered, and that we were able to put in these centers, and it was incredibly high quality. And what I felt the major thing was, finally, textile arts really We're there in mainstream art, and it's like there's no turning back now. There's no question that every one of the exhibitions was a top-notch exhibition for that gallery in terms of even what to date they have shown in the history of those galleries. Some of them were some of the top exhibits. And so I think that's really significant that it's part of a major textile arts event, that it's recognized around the world, that all the artists who participated were, I think, thrilled to participate. So this was very important to me as a textile artist, as an organizer of textile exhibitions, as a artistic director of Moon Range Center, and working with the Triennial to really put textile arts on the map. So I thought we did a good job.
I have one more question. What happens at Moon Range in winter? Do you give workshops?
Yes, very often we give workshops. Everything depends on what else we're doing. Sometimes we're doing community tapestry projects or artists in the schools projects. Sometimes I'm traveling for an exhibition somewhere. So everything depends on the schedule, where our energies are at the moment. We hope to be programming workshops. Right now, nothing. Right now, we're trying to wrap up the Triennial and put together our final reports. As we mentioned, Gabby has a solo exhibition coming up. I have an exhibition at the Table in Ottawa, and I'm part of an exhibition at the Chelsea Art Center, Artist Books, I think, in November. So right now we have other little things. We need to take a deep breath and then sort of begin to think about future programming.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.